Welcome back, everybody! I have one question for you. Who's ready for combat? That's what I thought. If you were here a little bit earlier today, you saw some amazing wand combat choreography. But what you are about to see is even more intense. And we have got some bad guys up here on the stage. Are you ready? Then I want you to keep that applause going all the way from Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, the making of Harry Potter, the world's only wand combat choreographer. Give it up for Paul Harris!
Hey! Good afternoon, how are you? You're still here. So, how many of you have been to a wand combat workshop before? A few. I'm discounting this morning. Discounting this morning. How many of you have been to a wand combat workshop before? Okay. Well, this one is going to be slightly different from any that have been done here before. And just to give you a little bit of background around what we're going to do today, you may or may not know that I was the choreographer of Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. So I created the battle scene. Thank you. The scene with Voldemort and Dumbledore, and the death of Sirius Black. I'm sorry about that, it was in the script. Now, in the process of that, I was given a remit of coming up with a physical language, a grammar, for using the wand that would serve the rest of the franchise, whatever that may be, whether it was one movie, five movies, or 20 movies. So it had to be a language that would not undermine what had already gone, but would facilitate what was yet to come. So if you've seen it on YouTube or any of the fan sites, or you've been to a one combat demonstration before, then you'll know that what I came up with essentially was five movements as the basis of attack, and five movements that are the basis of defense. And my rationale for that was that I thought, well, if the entirety of ballet can come from five positions, and if Kung Fu can come from a set of positions, then so can this. Because what I couldn't do was, I couldn't do one movement for one spell, because every spell that J.K. Rowling had written had already been executed with little or no physical action. So I had to create something that would encompass everything. So when I normally do a one combat workshop, I normally expand on that more and explain what those movements are. But today, we're going to do something slightly different, because I'm going to direct this as if you guys were supporting artists in a movie. So instead of teaching them in the sequential order that I taught the actors, I'm still going to teach you the movements that we did for attack and defense, but I'm going to teach you them in a different order. The reason for that being that once you have mastered the positions in one combat or kung fu or ballet or whatever it may be, those positions are then used for you to access choreography. Choreography being hello, would you like to join in there? That's it, good. Choreography being the result of all of those things put together for creative movement. So that's what we're going to do today. So I have two assistants to help me. So please welcome Rusty and Erin on stage with me, please. And I'm going to take you through, I need everybody to stand up for a start, come on. I know you've had lunch and everything. Now, this is not bad, this is fairly even. And this is going to work well for what we're going to do today. Now, initially, all of the actors on all of the films from Order of the Phoenix onwards went through the same process, and all of the Death Eaters who are working around the world go through the same process in a particular order. But I'm going to take you through a different order. So we're going to start with what is essentially move number three. Move number three. Now you need to lock these into your memory, because once you've got them, I'm going to then ask you to do them in a different order. You're going to choose your own order out of this sequence. Right? So move number three. Flex your knees, get down, bring your free arm across, your protective arm. Now the reason for this is because, now remember, you're all supporting artists in the film. Now the people that you're gonna fight are powerful wizards. Some of them, Voldemort, for example, they don't even need a wand. They can, Voldemort disarms Harry Potter without a wand, right? In the Order of the Phoenix, he just dismisses him and his wand falls to the ground. So your free arm is very important, depending on your power as a wizard. Bring your free arm across your body and bring your wand arm underneath your free arm, rotating it inwards to get the swish and the flick. Now those of you that were at the kids' workshop this morning, I want you to have a lot more detail in this. Get down, free arm across, wand arm across the body, bring your make your body on as flat a plane as you can. So you're narrowing your center to your enemy. Swish and flick. Move, rotate the wand inwards. Yes, very good. So there's a real finality to the movement. I want to hear. Hey, I want to hear it. You're supposed to be a fearsome army of Death Eaters. I want to hear it. Ready? And action! Not bad, not bad, not bad, not bad. So, from there, this is move number three in the actual order that you would learn at one training school. Well, you're then gonna immediately go to what is move number one. So you're gonna move from this position. You don't necessarily need to move your feet, you can, but it's difficult to move from what is called horse dance in Kung Fu, or second position plie in dance. It's difficult to move from there to another second position. So I want you to bring your wand arm back above your head, rotate the wand inward, still get the same finality. And what we want is a nice clean curve above your head with the wand lined up with your counterbalancing arm. So bend your knees, get down. The lower you are, the stronger you are against the target. So let's go from three to one, please. So ready, stand by for action. Three and then one. Here we go. Stand by. Action. Three, one. I want to see everyone do that. Let me have a look. Bend your knees, get down. You're all too high. Get down, get down. Really low. Here we go. Stand by. Move number three, followed by move number one. And action! One! Oh, good! Very good! Lovely movement back there. Okay. Now, from move number one, we're going to move through to move number four. Now, move number four is a very crucial movement. When a movie is made of the scale of Harry Potter, you have what's called a storyboard. Have any of you heard of that phrase before? A storyboard is a set of drawings which initially realizes the vision of the director, who is interpreting the vision of the scriptwriter, who is interpreting the vision of, in this case, J.K. Rowling. So you have a set of people to go through, and then it was my job to interpret that physically. Now, one of the movements on the storyboard that was very important was a drawing of Ginny firing a shot behind her. So the drawing actually had her moving and just literally firing the shot without looking. She was running along the Hall of Prophecies and she fired the shot behind her. So that's the shot that we're gonna use, but you're gonna go, you're gonna take that from move number one. So you've done the first movement. Then you're gonna turn, if you're right-handed, you're gonna turn to the right. If you're left-handed, it will be to the left. So your back is to me, and you're gonna fire that shot behind you. Directly behind you. Now, we still need a real, you need satellite navigation over there. We still need a finality to the movement. So I don't want to see you shooting the ground. Bring the wand up so it's parallel and aim at the height that you want to do the damage. So you're in move number one, hands above the head. Your wand arm is above the head. Your free arm is lined up to counterbalance and aim at your target. You're gonna turn through to move number four and action! Good. Right, let's go through now from 3, 1, 4. Here we go. Prepare, everybody prepare. Stand by. Action! 3, 1, 4! Oh, but your life is at stake. I want to hear it. Venom, give me some venom. Here we go, ready? Stand by, ready? Action, 3, 1, 4. Oh, not bad. I thought it was not bad. Right, good. So, we're now in the sequence that you would learn in one training school. We're going to then go to move number two. So your back is to the target. Your back is to the target. If you're right-handed, you're gonna continue to turn to the right. If you're left-handed, it'll be the other way. So you're turning to the right, you're gonna bring your wand arm forward and aim it at your enemy. I'm aiming right now, absolutely, down the center there at a lady called Kim. Here we go. Rotate the wand inside, inwards. Inwards, finality. Ah! I can't hear you. Good, inwards. Real finality, very good. Very good. Here we go, so we're in move. We are in position number four. We're continuing to turn. The crucial action will be the rotation for the swish and flick, and action! Ha! Not bad. So, we have 3, 1. What's next? Good, let me have a look. Stand by. Here we go. All the way through. Ready, and action! Oh, good, very nice. Do you think you were the best? Do you think you were the best? Three, one, four, two, cut. Stand by, ready, and action, 3, 1. Good. Okay, now, from position number two, we're going to repeat movement number one. So from here, you're gonna step back into that and fire one again. So you're on your front leg, either split your center between 2 feet or have your weight leaning into the front leg. Propel yourself backwards, bring your arm beautifully above your head in a clean curve, and still get the switch and the flick. Now, there's a gorgeous shot. The actual shot that was used in the movie is a gorgeous shot of Helena Bonham Carter in that position when she kills Sirius Black. The aesthetic shape of her arm is perfect. I'm sorry. I told you, it was in the script. No, don't blame me. So, we're here in position number two. You're gonna step back, and fire number one, action! Oh, they made a noise without being asked. That was very good. Okay, 2-1, here we go. So we're in move number two, step back. Ha! Good. Now, the very last movement, and the person who the drawing of this on the storyboard was about is here this weekend. It was a drawing of Malfoy. And actually, for your info, something that most people won't know is that of all of the principal cast, Jason Isaacs was involved the most in the creation of what we did for One Combat. My assistant and I and Jason worked together really a lot in coming up with what we came up with. So this drawing was on the storyboard and it was of him. So you're in this position number one. You don't move. Anchor yourself here and bring your one arm behind your back. Bring your hips forward so that you can fire the one behind your back. Fire the one behind your back. So it's from 1 to 5. This movement behind the back in One Combat positioning is position number 5. So you're going from position 1 to position 5. But still with venom. Ready? And action! Oh, good. So we have 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5. Shout it out for me. Here we go.
3, 1, 4, 2, 1.
Guys, if I were you, really, I would avoid alcohol at lunch. Once more, please. 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5. Want to hear it?
3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5.
I'm sure that's right. Okay, once more, from the top, all together. Here we go. Stand by. Ready? Prepare and action. 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5. Not bad, not bad, not bad. The A group over here, can I have a look? This side over here, stand by. Ready? And action! Oh, not bad. Okay. Now the best group, oh sorry, the other group over here. Here we go. Ready, and action! Do you know what? Whatever you're taking, can I have some? Very good. Okay, right, now, this is the tricky bit. What I would like you to do is take a moment between you. Now, we're going to come down amongst you because, remember, you guys are all supporting artists in a movie. I want you to reorder that as you wish. A few of you could keep it the same order, but I want you to come up with a different order from 3, 1, 4, 2, 1, 5. Any order you want, because very shortly you're going to have someone to fight against. So here we go. Come on, come up with an order. Let's go down and work with them. So choose a different order. Very good. Yeah. 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 Any order you want. Very good. Hello. I remember you. You were on stage. Whoa. I remember. Come on, a different order. You've only got minutes. There's a very big budget at stake. Do it quickly. You got an order? You got an order? Tell me your order. Yorkshire, tell me your order. Oh, anyone from Lancashire here? No. Okay, good. How are we doing over here? You got an order? Again? 14235. One missing. Okay, so let me see you all. I want you to call out your individual order. It should create a massive noise. Let me hear everyone. Wait, all together with the actions. Do your movement. Here we go. Let me have a look. Stand by. And action. That was not bad, actually. That was not bad. This group, let me see. Give me, guys. If this were really moving and you were really supporting us and I was directing this, what I'd be saying to you is, I know it's great fun, I know you're having a great time, but I don't want to see that. Your life is at stake. I want you to get down, picture yourself in that situation. Someone's going to kill you!
Yeah.
So, get down, call out your order. You look quite fearsome. Oh, wow. Okay, here we go, stand by. Ready? Action! Now, also, aside from, guys, listen, the sort of direction that you would get, aside from the fact I don't want to see you having a great time, is not to pick up on this, not for everyone to pick up the same rhythm. And when you're learning it, of course, you're going, but in reality, when people fight in any form of combat, that doesn't apply. Your opponent is not gonna fight you at the rhythm of your choosing. So try to choose a different rhythm. It could be that after the first movement, you could be there for ages and you move forward and then you fire another shot. It doesn't necessarily have to follow on rhythmically. So try and change the rhythm as well as the order. Let's see, let's have a look at this side. Here we go. Stand by. Ready? Action! Oh, good. Hey, they were very good. Right, let's see you lot again. There's more of you, and they're winning. Stand by. This side, ready? Action! Very good. All together. Let's one more time, all together. Here we go. Stand by. And action! All right, that's not bad. I'm seeing lots of different heights. That's good. Seeing lots of different physicality. It's still all a bit jolly, considering you're about to be killed. I would like to see more, I'd like it to be a little more earnest, a little more threatening, and a little more care for your life. Once more, real attack, please. Stand by, ready, action! Not bad. Well, for a first rehearsal, it's not bad. So, if you were a bunch of supporting artists in a big movie, and this was a crowd scene, you would have to have someone to fight against. So guess what? I have some people for you to fight against right here, right now!
Thank you.
Now you're really going to have to pull out your wands properly. So here we go. How this would occur, how this would progress if this was a film, is that ideally, depending on the budget of the movie, there would be a fantastic master wide shot of all of you people fighting all of the of these Death Eaters. So the Death Eaters are going to block you. This group are going to attack this group of Death Eaters, and this group are going to attack this group of Death Eaters. Are you all ready? At the same time initially, and then we'll split it up and we'll do two separate shots. Here we go. Stand by. Stand by. I want to hear it. Venom, attack. Your life is at stake. Action! Keep going. Sustain it. Repeat your sequence until the Death Eaters are stunned and they collapse. And there they go. That's one group gone. And another group. Death Eaters collapse. Okay. Dude, it's in the script. Collapse. Okay. So, now, I want to see that again. This side only. And then this side only. So this is how it would be. They would be separated out into shots. So this side, Death Eaters, let's have you up again, please. Here we go. This side only. This is for a shot of this side. Here we go. Real venom. I need more depth, more attack, more aggression. Here we go. And action. Sustain it. Keep it going. And the Death Eaters start to collapse. One down, another one down, and another one down. Okay, now let's have a look at this side. Here we go. So you guys are completely out of shot at the moment. All the focus is on this side. Stand by and action! Death Eaters start to collapse! Very good! Very good! Now, I'd like to bring our Death Eaters back on stage with me, please. Death Eaters, come up the middle channel on stage with me, please. Here we go. Keep your eyes focused on the Death Eaters, but they're not done with you yet. Boo! Rubbish! Boo! She's like, come on! Okay. Now, before our grand finale, I want to show you two other movements that were used in the Voldemort-Dumbledore duel, which have become quite iconic. And I wanted all of the Death Eaters on stage to show these two movements. In the storyboard of Order of the Phoenix, there were two drawings, both of which I realized physically and both of which made it to the final cut. The first one is the Rope of Fire. Now, that's written in the book and it's also in the script and it was in the storyboard. And basically what happens is the more powerful wizards are able to conjure up fire by creating the shape of a rope around their body. So I want you all to take your wand arm, bring it around the body in a big circle, do not eliminate the swish and the flick at the end. So you still gotta have that. So big circle, stand by guys, here we go. Around and ah! And then hold it there. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Because they're gonna lock the fire onto the fire that's coming out of your wand, hopefully. But from what I heard, I think they would win. Here we go, stand by, rope of fire. Ah! Ah! Hold it, hold it, hold it. Come on, hold it with strength and cut. Okay, then there was another movement in which, I don't know if you recall, but Voldemort shatters all the glass in the atrium. Do you remember that? And then the direction that I gave to Ray Fiennes for this movement was to gather up all of the glass, guys, gather up all of the glass and bring it forward like a banderillas, which is the stick that kills the bull in a bullfight. He gathers it all up above the head, and fire it forward. Ah! That's it. So you're gathering all of the elements. It could be the railings, it could be sand, it could be dirt, it could be furniture, it could be anything. You gather it all up and fire it forward. Ready? Stand by and gather, 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 gather! Action! Good. Let me see that. This group. Ready? Rope of fire into the banderillas. Ready? Here we go. And rope of fire. And hold it, hold it, hold it. Break. And banderillas movement. And not bad. This side, rope of fire. And action. Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it. And cut. And banderillas movement, big movement, big movement. Ah! Good. Now, for our finale, what you're gonna do, we've got some openings here. I want you all to file through as many as possible into the central channel, come down here, peel off along here, and then when you all get to the front, you're gonna execute your routine, the order that you came up with for yourself, at the Death Eaters, all six movements, followed by the rope of fire, followed by the banderillas. Are we ready for that? Do we have clear openings in the fence? Clear openings. Emily, put your hand up, please. Down the bottom there. Start to file through. Can we bring them through? Emily, can we bring them through? Here we go. Yeah, that's it, hold it there, hold it there. Start to come through, start to come through. Start. We'll line you up first. Come down, hold it there. So about there, about there. About, actually go back a little. Start to come through, people. Start to come through. Come on, I want this channel full of people. Full of people, come on. Into this channel. Everyone come through into this channel. Everyone come through. That's it, there. That's it. Go further forward. Fill the channel with people. Fill the channel. That's very good. Stay there, stay there, stay there. Stay there. Is it full? Is it full of people? Okay, right. Get your wands at the ready. So I want you to pick up a rhythm. You're gonna walk like you're advancing in Les Miserables. You're gonna walk at the stage, at the stage. Peel off half of you there, half of you there. Fill it, and then we'll fight the Death Eaters in the order that you came up with. Are we ready? Stand by. Here we go. And action. Come through, come through. Music, come through. Peel off, peel off, peel off, peel off. Some of you that way, some of you that way. Go that way, go that way, go that way. Go that way, go that way, go, go, go. Go, move through, move through, move through, move through. Line up, look at them. Here we go, get ready. With you, the order of your routine. Action! And rope of fire! Ah, hold it, hold it, hold it! And a banderillas, cut! teammates are going to go one by one. One! And another one! And another one! And another one! So, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring our Death Eaters back up. A huge round of applause. Thank you, Death Eaters. Thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, you are absolutely fantastic. So thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it and see you again same time tomorrow. Thank you. Bye.
Thank Warner Brothers Studio Tour London, the making of Harry Potter, for letting us borrow you for the whole weekend. Give it up for the vanquishers of our Death Eaters! That was so intense! Did you guys have a good time? Did any of you see the bird that took off? It was like, I am getting out of here. Did you see that? All right, folks, we are still having so much fun here at a celebration of Harry Potter weekend. We have this stage full of activity at 4 o'clock, people. The stars that you have been waiting for will be up on this stage.